Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on engineering thermodynamics, and we are discussing the topic properties of steam, and this is lecture number 2 in the properties of steam. We recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discuss the formation of steam and the properties of steam. We introduce the steam table, how to refer steam table to take the properties of the steam. And here in this lecture, we will discuss about the again properties of steam with reference to diagrams. So, pressure volume diagram, pressure temperature diagram, temperature volume diagram, temperature entropy diagram, enthalpy entropy diagram, and PVT surface. So, PV, PT, TV, TS and HS diagrams and the PVT surface. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to draw the PV diagram, TV diagram, PT diagram, TS diagram, HS diagram of the steam, and able to explain the different terminologies, different points on the PV and all the diagrams. And the student will be able to draw the PVT surface, the three-dimensional representation of pressure, volume, temperature of the steam. That is what the PVT surface, three-dimensional diagram. So, we are going to discuss the property diagram, steam property diagram. So, temperature volume diagram, pressure volume diagram, pressure temperature diagram, temperature entropy diagram, enthalpy entropy diagram, and the PVT surface. We take the first diagram, temperature volume diagram. Once again, we recall the diagram that represents the formation of the steam. The steam is heated from 0 degrees Celsius. The water is heated from 0 degrees Celsius and converted into water at the saturated condition, then converted into wet steam, dry steam, and the superheated steam. So, the different formation from water at the 0 degrees Celsius to superheated steam, there are different stages and different forms. So, earlier we have drawn the temperature diagram with constant pressure. Now, we draw the temperature volume diagram. So, we take the specific volume in the x axis, temperature in the y axis, and we draw line at the constant pressure, 1 atmospheric pressure, and starting from 20 degrees Celsius. So, 20 degrees Celsius, the water is heated, and this water is called as compressed liquid. So, when the water is, water temperature is less than the saturation temperature, then the liquid is called as compressed liquid or subcooled liquid. Now, point 2 is 100 degrees Celsius. So, at atmospheric pressure, the saturation temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, it is saturated liquid. Then, the heat is added further, and the heat and the temperature is constant, and the water is converted into steam. So, 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. So, everything is saturated mixture, and it is point 2 is completely liquid at saturated condition. Point 4 is completely vapor, dry saturated vapor at a saturated condition, and the point 3 is the wet steam. So, point 3 is the wet steam, which is a mixture of water and water particle and the steam. Then, point 4 is dry saturated steam. So, further we are heating, it becomes superheated vapor, superheated steam. So, the temperature volume diagram for a particular pressure, atmospheric pressure, starting from 20 degree Celsius. So, this is for a particular pressure. Now, we take another temperature volume diagram for different pressure. Say, for example, this is point. So, earlier we have drawn 1 atmospheric pressure, 0.1 megapascal. So, here 0.01 megapascal, which is 0.1 bar, and this is 10 megapascal, which is 10 bar, 1 megapascal is 10 bar, this is P equal to 8 megapascal, which is 80 bar. Now, look at the diagram. So, for the lower pressure, 0.01 megapascal, so this is saturated liquid and this is saturated vapor. So, the length of the line is called as, it is latent heat of evaporation, latent heat of evaporation. And this is called as the mixture of wet steam. So, between saturated liquid and saturated vapor, so in between we have the wet steam, and this line represents the evaporation process. So this line, horizontal line, represents the evaporation process. Then we take the second line. So the length of the evaporation process is decreasing. When you go to the higher pressure, further the length of the saturation evaporation line is decreasing. So the latent heat of evaporation is decreasing as the pressure increases. So what do you mean by that? This is saturated liquid, this is saturated vapor. The length between saturated liquid and saturated vapor is keep on decreasing, and at a particular pressure where 22.06 megapascal or 220.6 bar. So this is the point where we cannot, so the two points are merging, two points are joined together. So saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line, they are joined together, and this point is called as critical point, where the pressure is 22.06 megapascal, and this point is critical point where you cannot distinguish between the liquid and the vapor, and the corresponding temperature is called as critical temperature, which is 373.95 degree Celsius. So for water, right, the critical pressure is 22.06 bar, 22.06 megapascal, and temperature is 373.95 degree Celsius, and this is called as critical point where we cannot distinguish between water and the vapor, water vapor, or liquid and the water vapor, the saturated liquid and saturated vapor. So the two phases will coexist here. That is the point. Now, so what we do? So from this diagram, so saturated liquid point, saturated liquid point, saturated liquid point. So left hand side, we have saturated liquid point. Right hand side, we have saturated vapor point. Now we connect all the saturated vapor line to the critical point and connect all the saturated liquid line to the critical point, and this is what the line. Again, we take the TV diagram. So this is the line which indicates the saturated liquid line, and this is the line which indicates the saturated vapor line. So the saturated vapor line and saturated liquid line, they are joining, meeting at the point, critical point. So what is the, so this diagram is very, very important. This type of diagram is very, very important for all our future discussion. So this is left hand side line, it is called as saturated liquid line. What do you mean by that? Anywhere on this line, it is saturated liquid. Right hand side line, it is saturated vapor line. That means anywhere on the line, it is saturated vapor. So on the left side of the saturated liquid line, it is called as compressed liquid region or subcooled liquid. On the right hand side of the saturated vapor line, it is called as superheated vapor region. And in between saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line, it is saturated liquid plus vapor region, that is called as wet region. So in this diagram, in the central area, it is meant for the wet steam. Right hand side area, it is for the superheated steam. And left side area is for the subcooled liquid. And this is the critical point. Normally, at undergraduate level, all our calculation, it will be between after the saturated liquid. So only in this diagram, not beyond the critical point. So we'll be discussing only less than the critical point, and we'll do all the property calculation, all the vapor power cycle, everything within the critical point. So this you have to remember, and this should be, you should be able to draw the temperature volume diagram. So the next diagram, pressure volume diagram. So as we explained in the temperature volume diagram, so this is pressure volume diagram. Now the saturated, we straight away start with the saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line, critical point, compressed liquid region and superheated vapor region, and this is the wet region. Now the lines are constant temperature. Look at the constant temperature line. So the temperature is decreasing. This is the saturation temperature, and temperature remains constant, and the temperature is decreasing. So this is what the T2 is constant and T1 is constant. For different temperatures, you can draw the temperature line in the PV coordinate. Then we take the pressure temperature diagram. This is very popularly known as phase diagram. So you look at the diagram, pressure in the Y axis, temperature in the X axis. So there are three lines that are connecting at the triple point. So triple point is the point where all the three phases of water coexist. What are the three phases? Solid phase, liquid phase, and vapor phase. They coexist here in the triple point. And this is the solid phase, this is the liquid phase, and this is the vapor phase. So the solid phase means it is ice. So this is the fusion curve. So when you move along this curve, the amount of solid is decreasing and it becomes water here. At this point it becomes water. And the liquid phase to vaporization curve. So when you move in this line, it becomes vapor. So from the triple point, when you move along this line, so the vapor is solid, water is converted into vapor, and this is the critical point. So where the liquid phase, and we cannot distinguish between liquid phase and the vapor phase. All our property calculation are between triple point and the critical point. And this is another diagram for pressure temperature. So this is the triple point, and we have the critical point, fusion curve, this is the fusion curve, vaporization curve, and the sublimation curve. So sublimation curve, sublimation is the process where the solid is directly converted into vapor. So solid is converted into vapor, that is what the sublimation process. Liquid is converted into vapor, that is the vaporization process. Solid is converted into liquid, that is what the fusion process, fusion curve. So this is the pressure temperature diagram or phase diagram of steam. And temperature entropy diagram, so this is required for all our thermodynamic cycles, thermodynamic processes. So the x axis is taken as entropy, y axis is taken as temperature, and once again we have the saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line. So the constant pressure lines are drawn here. So these are all constant pressure lines. So for various pressures we are drawing the line, and this is the critical point where the pressure is 221.2 bar and temperature is 374.15 degree Celsius. So the critical pressure is 221.2 bar and critical temperature is 374.15 degree Celsius. And here when you look closer to the diagram, so we have two important parameters. One is superheating, another one is subcooling. So the temperature of subcooling, so below the saturation temperature, so this is the saturation temperature, below the saturation temperature when you cool, that is called as subcooling. So this point is subcooling, and above the saturation temperature when you heat, that is called as superheating. So that subcooling and superheating, that you have to remember. And the enthalpy entropy diagram, so this is the Mollier chart. So Mollier chart is a big chart available along with your steam table. So it is only enthalpy entropy diagram. So enthalpy is taken in the y axis and entropy, specific entropy, is taken in the x axis, and you have the saturated liquid line, critical point, and saturated vapor line, and the constant pressure lines are drawn here. So if you look at the constant pressure line, they are diverging. They are diverging in the right side direction, and after the saturated vapor line, you may find the temperature lines also. So this is Mollier diagram. So this is available with your steam table. So the enthalpy entropy diagram. Then this is the PVT surface. So three-dimensional representation of all the phases, the formation of steam here. So the y-axis pressure, x-axis volume, and z-axis the temperature. So pressure, volume, and temperature. So if you look at here, so this is the critical point, and here we have the liquid phase, and this is the solid phase, and this is the fusion curve, and this is the triple point line, So here we have the vapor, and below the triple point we have the solid vapor interface, that is the sublimation. And here we have the liquid vapor interface, that is the wet steam, and here it is superheated steam, it is the compressed liquid or unsaturated liquid, and here it is completely solid, that is ice formation. So normally you have to draw the diagram carefully and explain the different terminologies here. Liquid, so compressed liquid, unsaturated or subcooled liquid, critical point where you cannot distinguish between liquid and the vapor, so this is the vapor phase, superheated vapor. So between these two lines we have the liquid vapor interface, that is called as wet steam, the triple point line. So the triple point is the temperature at which you cannot distinguish between the three phases, solid, liquid, and the vapor. So like that you have to write few points on the in your notebook. So you take the diagram and write down the point, what do you remember. So the solid phase, liquid phase, critical point, liquid vapor interface, triple point line, and a solid vapor interface and vapor line, and you have to write down in your type, in a small paragraph of 5 to 6 sentences. We stop here. So these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So you can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I will answer. So thank you for watching, and we will meet again.